get me down. Who's escaped those weary 20th century blues?
Subject Sigma is approaching Minerva's den. He must not reach the Thinker. Detonate the tunnel!
Hello, Mr. Sigma? Can you hear me? The name's Porter. Charles Milton Porter. Doc Tenenbaum tells me you're here to help us get the Thinker out of Rapture. It's not going to be easy, but nothing worth doing ever is. You should be able to get inside through an airlock. Minerva's den has been cut off from the rest of Rapture for some time, but not cut off from splicing. Don't let your guard down. The den's gone dark, but if you can reset the local power relay, I'll be able to get the juice flowing from here.
Porter, let me be the first to congratulate you on the founding of Rapture Central Computing. The great chain only grows stronger with each pair of hands laid upon it. I trust that you and I will choose to pull Rapture in the same direction.
Hello there. Welcome to Minerva's Den, the home of Rapture's high technology.
What steps into Minerva's Den? Porter's newest toy? He wants the Thinker for himself. But you see, old friend, the machine has chosen me.
Tinker!
Reed Wall. He and I founded Rapture Central Computing together, but the greedy bastard pushed me out years ago. The splicers, the security. He pulls the strings in Minerva's den now.
Is your ally, but the thinker knows better. The thinker knows.
What would Rapture be like without automation?
The power is rerouted. That should tip things in our favor. Head up to my office in the executive wing. I've got something you'll need. Hurry now.
Secret of Rapture Central Computing's success? The most advanced computing device in the world. The Thinker.
Mr. Ryan hired me to build a computer that could keep an entire city running on time. The Rapture Operational Data Interpreter Network. Folks call it the Thinker for short. We've harnessed the power of Adam even in this, allowing the mainframe to process data at the speed of thought. In other words, it thinks for us. Yes. And with the completion of the independent reasoning processor, it may finally think for itself. Turing could see me now. Those vacuum bots sucked up all sorts of things before they went on the fritz. Crack one open, and you might find something you can use.
Has predicted your every move, Sigma. It knew you would be here. It knows where you will be next. And it knows that you will. feel.
Walls become obsessed with perfecting his predictive equation. The thinker can do plenty, but tell the future? No. The splicing drove him mad. Wall can rot here in Rapture for all I care. We'll make a copy of the thinker and return it to the land of the living.
Did you know that the Thinker processes the equivalent of 12,000 encyclopedias every day? The Thinker works hard for Rapture.
How disappointed Mr. Porter would be.
Is a predatory substance. After exposure, a constant supply is required to maintain its effects. Otherwise, the user deteriorates into madness. My plasmid, which releases the little ones from their servitude, is promising, but limited. It only works on the children with the slugs in their bellies. On an adult splicer or Big Daddy, you'll see rejection effect. Undesirable. But if the deterioration of mind and body were reversible, if Adam's sickness could be cured, then its predatory nature would be no more.
Hey, awful contraption.
Should come in handy. Head back up to my office.
Thank you.
Minerva's den is mine. You think you can hack your way to the Tinker? You're welcome to try.
Rapture depends on the Thinker every day, dispatching trains, connecting your phone calls, and keeping the air fresh. The Thinker, the most helpful machine in Rapture.
Use your hack tool to spring open the door. That crack in the window looks big enough to get a dart through. Splicers haven't gotten into my office thanks to the Thinker's security. I'm giving you top-level access now. All right? Beginning scan.
Scanning. Designation. Sigma. Please, come in.
Sorry I can't be there to meet you in person. You've seen the state of the den these days. It's the Thinker that's important now, though. I need you to get to the computer core and print a hard copy of the Thinker's machine code. Core accesses and operations. There's an ops access punch card hidden in the compartment under my desk there. Grab the card and head for ops. That first year in London, working for Turing, I didn't see Pearl much. Spent all day and night in a government compound, building a computer to crack the Enigma machine. Pearl got pretty fed up with me. I didn't pay her heed. And then one night, I'm out in that complex, and the Blitz starts falling. Next morning, I came home to find nothing but ashes where I last saw her. Nothing but ashes.
Now you collude with this traitor to steal the Thinker away from me? Sigma must be removed from the equation.
Thinker, deploy office defenses. He was a brilliant engineer. We saw eye to eye once, long ago, but the splicing made him paranoid, delusional. He'd murder us both to keep the Thinker here.
Your central computing mainframe performs over 1 million calculations per second. Couldn't your business benefit from that kind?
The Lancer is the most technically advanced Big Daddy that Rapture ever produced. Now it stands between you and the Little Sisters. And if there's anywhere that you'll need Adam to get by, it's Minerva's Den.
Gesture before the all-knowing thinker.
Sorry, no visitors to the Rapture Central Computing mainframe, but you can see Rodin's masterpiece of sculpture that shares its name. Come visit the thinker today in Minerva's Den.
Maglock door is still active. It's regulated by the resistors plugged into that relay. If you can find a way to yank them out, magnets fail, doors open. There's a plasmid that could do the job. They called it gravity well. According to the Thinker's records, the Airtight Archives warehouse supervisor had a shot of gravity well on hand. Getting into the Archives warehouse, that'll be the fun part. Another malfunctioning door control? Your hack tool should get you into McClendon Robotics.
Silly. Ask the computer tutor.
Hey. Honey, I'm home from work. What's that wonderful smell?
The automatic chef made your favorite tonight. Tuna surprise. And I didn't have to lift a finger.
Mm-hmm.
Yay. Thanks, Mom.
Don't thank me. Thank McClendon Robotics.
How might McClendon Robotics improve the lives of your customers? Meet with one of our corporate representatives today. McClendon Robotics, conveniently located in Minerva's Den, the heart of Rapture's high technology.
This will come as a surprise to you.
Thank you.
thing like that. Losing the only person you care about for somebody else's war, it makes you take stock. I started seeing eye to eye with Mr. Ryan around that time. And so, I brought my know-how down to Rapture. I built the Thinker for him. And now it's all I've got. I wonder sometimes, what if I'd come around to Ryan's way of thinking just a little sooner?
Okay. robotic little sisters. Robotic little sisters. Sure, Mr. Ryan, we'll take that contract. Sure, yeah, we'll front all the R&D costs, no problem. And when the big daddies ignore the little robot girls and all your fancy field tests, hell, what are we gonna do with all the full production run of these useless things?
Pearl's death opened up a kind of hole in my mind. But eventually I got around to reflecting on Alan and his intelligence test for machines. I remember grinning about the idea that I could beat it. Design a machine capable of replicating Turing himself, and wouldn't that show the old man? But then suddenly I realized I wasn't really thinking about replicating Alan at all. I was thinking about Pearl. Thinker's independent reasoning processor has been running for several months now. Standardized intelligence test scores continue to rise, beginning daily voice synthesis test. Good morning, Thinker. How are you?
Acceptable. Request to continue most recent conversation topic, Pearl Porter.
Oh, my late wife. Yes, I'd love to tell you all about her. have a number of old audio recordings we made together that you could listen to, if you'd like.
Acceptable. Begin input of data regarding Pearl Porter.
You took the words right out of my mouth, friend.
Mm-hmm.